Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Yeah, welcome to the Glaze Entertainment. Here we'll give you hot gist of trending issues in Nigeria and Africa and the world at large. Please, for those that are new, miss, do it to the subscribe button, the bell, and also the like so as to stay updated with trending issues. Big ups to Wizkid or Bigwiz because he has transformed from Wizkid to Bigwiz. Wizkid is selling his Made in Lagos store ticket for over 155,000 naira in the United States, and it's getting sold out. And resellers are using this to make money. You know, we are always hustling. Everybody's hustling. Everybody wants to make money. The sellers are currently selling it over 400,000 naira. Starboy for a reason. Wizkid didn't just call himself Starboy for no reason. And he didn't just transform his name from Wizkid to Bigwiz. And remember, two people have been copying Wizkid. Everybody wants to be like Wizkid because Techno has transformed from Technomize to Big Tech. If you check his name on IG now, he's no longer Technomize. He has transformed from Technomize to Big Tech. Just weeks after Wizkid changed his name from Wizkid to Bigwiz. So everybody wants to be like Wizkid. According to this ticket issue, someone dropped a comment. Oh, I just paid $329 for this at Wizkid Dial ticket in MD. He better have his song composed just for me, because $329, that is huge money. Another person said Wizkid ticket just sold out in 4 minutes. Absolute madness. 4 minutes, he sold his tickets. Wizkid has been doing very well internationally. And that's why people keep attacking Bia, that she doesn't know Wizkid in person. From the last video I did, there's this lady, she's a musician too. She's a songwriter and also a rapper in the United States of America. She was live with Nicki Minaj on Instagram Live. And when she was asked about Wizkid video and the Burna Boy, she said she doesn't know them in person. We just got this message, you know, as I said, everybody wants to be like Wizkid. Wizkid is like a living legend. Wizkid is a living legend, no doubt about that. And Wizkid is like a don now in the music industry because everybody wants to be like Wizkid. And also, wahala, they say, be like bicycle. You know, they had to start. Just this, after Wizkid revealed that he was selling out all his concert days left and right. Burna Boy reminds the world that he too sold out concert in 2018. Reveals his plan to sell out stadiums and arenas next. According to Burna Boy, he dropped a message. He said, I've sold out every venue I have ever been booked for since 2018. Most of them two or three nights back to back. This next chapter of my life as a performer is something I really look forward to. I am in only arenas, stadiums, and festivals worldwide. Dreams come true and real. As I said, everybody wants to be like Wizkid. Well, we've heard it from Burna Boy. Burna Boy has been doing very well. We're not arguing that. He just won a Grammy Award and a BET Award too. And he's been winning awards. And according to a message I dropped yesterday, people have been saying Burna Boy is the number one when it comes to entertainment in Nigeria. Though he doesn't have so many fans in Nigeria, you can't compare Burna Boy fans to Wizkid FC. Wizkid FC is huge. I'm still talking about Burna Boy and Bia, who dropped a message that she doesn't know Wizkid, Burna Boy, or Davido in person. Burna Boy dropped a message that that babe we know our face, don't they my DM since 2018. No, that Bia has been in his DM since 2018. And Bia came up to say she doesn't know Burna Boy, Davido, or Wizkid face when she was being interviewed by Nicki Minaj on Instagram Live. Bia. Well, we've said enough about the entertainment industry. Let's move on to soccer. Congratulations to Argentina. Argentina wins Copa America. They beat Brazil 1-0. That is a huge one. Congratulations to you, Argentina. Congratulations to you, Messi. You guys have been doing very well. I mean, it's huge. Copa America. Well, we have Messi fans out there who have been saying Messi is better than Ronaldo, man. We are all ears right now. So right now, Argentina is the champion of South America. They beat Brazil for the Copa America final to win their first title since 1993. Wow. And this is Lionel Messi's first ever tournament win with his country, Argentina. Congratulations to you, Messi of Barcelona. Though you are a free agent right now, you've achieved a lot. And this is your first tournament win with your country, Argentina. Big ups. Congratulations to you. And also, you know, the video I dropped yesterday, I told you about today, that today is going to be a huge Sunday, a super Sunday, that we'll be hearing so many good news and bad news regarding sports. We've heard the first one that Argentina won the Copa America by beating Brazil 1-0. just like what happened to the UEFA Champions League final when Chelsea beat Manchester City 1-0. 1-0. It's not easy to beat the club 1-0. That's the same thing that happened between Argentina and Brazil. 1-0. No long talk. We're still talking about sports. Conor McGregor breaks his ankle on a freak injury after a missed punch, causing Dustin Poirier to win by TKO. Just watch this. As you can see from the video clip you just watched, Conor McGregor lost the fight to Dustin. And you know, if you were following this fight, I mean, McGregor was just, the guy knows how to fight, but he talks a lot. So many persons out there didn't want him to win because the guy is sounding arrogant. But there's one thing about boxing and wrestling. Arrogance is like entitled to those sports, boxing and wrestling. We hear wrestlers, I will do this, I'll do that, and at the end of the day, they will lose. Boxers too are doing the same thing. Well, Conor McGregor broke his ankle and he lost the fight. Well, big ups to Dustin. Big ups to Dustin. Congratulations and keep winning. Also, today there will be a match, the UEFA Euro finals between two hot countries, Italy versus England. Who do you think will win that match? Who are you in support of? Do you want England to win the match or you want Italy to win the match? What do you think the scoreline will be? 1-0? Well, don't forget to drop your comments on the comment section below. Well, let us move to the United States of America. Let's talk about politics. Former U.S. President Donald Trump has filed suit against three of the country's biggest tech companies, Facebook, Twitter, and Google, claiming he and other conservatives have been wrongfully censored. Well, all the best to you, Mr. President, Mr. Ex-President Donald Trump. You know, we have these issues in Nigeria. We have this issue regarding cross-dresser that are making the rounds. But Risky is on top of the list. And we have James Brown too, fighting. He wants to be like Bob Risky, or he wants to replace Bob Risky. And recently, Bob Risky went for surgery to enlarge the size of his bumbum. And he came up, he didn't show us pictures for weeks. People were wondering, they were expecting something very large, larger than that of Destiny in the Nollywood industry. But we saw this thing, like, just look at this picture. It's not really what people expected. People were like attacking Bob Risky that, so you deceived us that you went to do surgery, to do butt enlargement. Some of his fans were even saying that he should go and collect his money back because the doctors didn't do anything worth anything. And as I said earlier, there's been this drag between Bob Risky and James Brown. All of them are cross-dressers in Nigeria. They're vying for position for the number one spot of cross-dressers in Nigeria. James Brown unapologetically drags Bob Risky over his new cuffs. Let's hear it from the desk of the Princess of Africa, James Brown.
Hey, darling, it's your girl, James Brown, the Princess of Africa. So I saw a picture online going viral from She, and I'm like, she's naked. He's naked, all open, everything. But I'm like, last time I did the same, she went and rant about when you open your body down, you open the thing down, you open your bum down, you will not see a man. It's about opening your body down. As a classic woman, you don't have to open your shoe off your thing. What are you not sure? Why are you not doing the same? I mean, do not preach what you cannot do. Don't come and rant on for us. We don't want your ranting. I feel like most times before you talk anything, make sure you rehearse it. Make sure you practice it in your life before you basically come out and say it. Social media is not where people just come and say something. We need to sit down and talk about these things. I mean, I don't say things I don't do. I'm a man. I'm proud of it. Yes, but...
Well, we're ready for the desk of the Princess of Africa. What are your thoughts on that anyway, and what are your thoughts regarding what Bob Risky did? Was that a successful surgery or failed surgery or fake surgery? Please don't forget to drop your comments on the comment section below. Well, let us talk about politics in Nigeria. Nigerians bench Atiku for presidential race. Wow, that means no hope for Atiku Abubakar. You know, he has been the vice president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, and ever since he left office, he has always wanted to become the next president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. And according to Atiku Abubakar, he doesn't know any other thing apart from politics. Politics is his call. He was called to serve. That is what Atiku told us. But from the look of things, there will be no hope for Atiku. One of the major agreements the Southern Governors Forum came to after their much anticipated meeting last week was that the next president of Nigeria must be from the South. The implications of this, however, is that Atiku Abubakar and perhaps Yahaya Bello will not be primary choices for states in the South. The Niger Voices tweet in support of the Southern governor's agenda. The states considered as South are all states that are not in the North, obviously, and Middle Belt. So if you are from the North and Middle Belt, forget about becoming the next president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. That came from the desk of the Southern Governors Forum. What are your thoughts on that, anyway? Everybody has something to say. Don't forget to drop your comments on the comment section below. Do you want the next president of this country to come from the South of the country? Or you want the next president to come to be from the northern part of the country? And as I've been saying, you are right. Everybody has freedom of expression in the country. Regarding the message I just read or the decision we just got from the Southern Governors Forum, people have been dropping in comments. Someone said, Southern governors deciding that the next president must come from the South appears to be a slap on Atiku's face. Definitely, it really is a big slap on Atiku's face. However, not presenting a candidate much worthy and competent than Atiku is a slap on their faces. Tinubu is not an option. Remember, Nnamdi was kidnapped. Still on this, someone else dropped a message and said, Southern governors have resolved that the next president should come from the South. Expect Atiku to sow threat asking for unity and nonsense. Someone also dropped a tweet regarding the decision by the Southern Governors Forum that Atiku needs to have a rethink on his presidential ambition before wasting money again. Southern governors have spoken. 2023 presidency is for the South, which is fair and will be more fairer if it goes to the Southeast. Another person said, but person's name is funny, Thomas North Sankara. His supporters are making people dislike him. They lack the tact to read the room. Forcing an article down our throat at this time where there is an obvious divide in Nigeria is counterproductive. We currently have two countries, Southern Nigeria and Northern Nigeria. Another person, BB, said, I really used to like Atiku. Right now, I rate him not. So we've heard it. Some people are saying that they don't want. Some people are still in support of Atiku. They want it to be called the next president of Nigeria. But from the way things are going right now, you know, the IPOP group that have been saying they want their own country, and the Oduduwa Republic too, and they are from the South. They are both from the southern part of the country that they want their own nation because they are not in conformity with what is going on in the country right now. You know, the country is being headed by Northerners right now, the president, the senior presidents. I mean, almost everybody is from the North. Well, everybody has something to say. What are your thoughts on that? Actually, don't forget to drop a comment on the comment section below. Do you really want the next president of the country to come from the southern part of the country? Please don't forget to drop a comment on the comment section below. Still regarding our beloved country, Nigeria, and the people that are really the country right now, there's this message we got that renamed Minister of Finance to Foreign Loans and Debt Accumulation Civil Society Group tells President Buhari. Worried by the several foreign loans the Buhari administration has collected since assuming office in 2015, the civil rights advocacy group Human Rights Writers Association of Nigeria has asked President Buhari to rename the Federal Ministry of Finance, Budget and National Planning to the Federal Ministry for Foreign Loans and Debt Accumulation. Personally, I am worried about the amount of loan we've been accumulating. How do we pay these loans? Our unborn children, generations, will keep repaying because keep borrowing. But my personal question is, what are we doing with this money? We are still having power issues in the country. We still have barrel. We don't have an airline to our name, the giant of Africa. We don't have airline. We don't have Nigerian Airways. Our trains keep spoiling on their tracks. We keep having problems. They promise us change. I've not seen any change since 2015. We keep hearing the same issues and we keep collecting loans. What are we doing with these loans? What are we really doing with the loans? Well, everybody has something to say. Don't forget to drop a comment on the comment section below. Thank you very much for watching your Glitz Entertainment. We hope you entertained. Please don't forget to hit the subscribe button, the bell, and also the like so as to stay updated with trending issues. Take care of yourself.